just about set to do battle with the Knights. It's a non-conference game. We'll be back in 60 seconds. You're listening to Mount Vernon Basketball on WMIX. Thank you.
So far, everybody's considerate.
Let's take it back out to Mount Vernon Rams Basketball Live with Rob Wilt and Dave Farley on WMIX.
Thank you, Carlos. By the way, Carlos Vasquez, an outstanding job, not only on the highlight reel from the championship game and the Salem tournament, but all year long. He's back in the studio, and he produces these broadcasts for you on WMIX, and I can't say enough good things about Carlos.
If you're going down Broadway, get him a couple of honks.
That's right.
Yeah.
That's Dave Farley. I'm Rob Wilt. Mount Vernon Rams starting lineup was just introduced. 6'5" junior Glendale Moore wears number 42. 6'2" junior Brian Deaton, he wears number 55. 6'4" senior Brian Gambler wears number 21. 6'2" senior Matt Green, he's number 25. And the point guard Aaron Harmon, a 5'10" junior, he wears number 24. For your modern-day Knights at Breeze, we've mentioned their starters in a pregame. The big kid in the middle is a 6'4" senior, Ryan Lake, averages 17, 18 points a game. 5'10" senior Jordan Krakey, 8 points a game. The good-looking sophomore Kyle Tolley, 5'11", he also averages 8 points a game. Another big sophomore, 6'3", Josh Donowalt, coming in at 6 points a game. And another senior, 5'10", Brandon Timmerman, coming off 5 points a game. As we mentioned, the Knights are coached by Marv Eversberg. He's in his fourth year as a head coach at Modern Day. He's been an assistant for 14 years before that. He's Modern Day grad back in 1970. Went to Quincy College, where he played 4 years of baseball and 2 years of basketball. And, of course, Mount Vernon, coached by Doug Creel. In his 10th year at the helm of Mount Vernon, he's assisted by Quinn McClure and Tim Holloway. The varsity game didn't go so well. Mount Vernon was defeated by the Modern Day JVs 58-29. We're on the stage here in this, definitely not a new gym, but it's really nice. We like it a lot. We're on the stage. Mount Vernon will shoot at our end here in the first half. The Rams are in their orange robe uniforms with black numerals trimmed in white. Modern Day in their white home uniforms with Carolina blue numerals trimmed in navy. Mount Vernon controls the opening tip, and Modern Day comes out in a 3-2 zone right off the bat. Left wing Green, on top Harmon, right wing Deaton, short corner to Glendale Moore, trying to work a little high-low with Gamber at the free throw line and Moore on the low block. Creel calls out the play, Green open for three out of the corner, yes, Matt Green buries the three, and the Rams break on top.
Another good start for the Rams.
Mount Vernon whipped it around the perimeter. Got a good look from Green. He buried it. Lake on top goes left wing to Timmerman. He looks inside. There's contact inside. And it'll go against Brian Deaton. He picks up his first foul of the contest. It's a veteran three-man crew. 7-11 left in the first period. Mount Vernon 3. Modern Day no score. This is their first possession. On top, Tolley. Goes left wing. Lake's right ankle heavily bandaged. A three put up and in. Kyle Tolley ties it up at three. Three-quarter court, 1-2-2 press. Gamber over the timeline. They drop back into a 3-2. Creel calls out the play. Gamber cuts through, gets it here in the left corner. Cross-court pass to Harmon. Looks inside to Deaton. Here comes Gamber running the baseline. Three out of the corner. Gamber, no good. Glendale Moore with the rebound. Puts it up strong, and he's fouled. Glendale go to the line to shoot two.
Glendale had a good angle on that shot. Saw that it was going to rebound out long toward the free throw line. And as a result of that, he'll get to shoot two at the free throw line. 3-3.
Foul was on Jordan Krakey, his first. Team fouls even at one apiece. Glendale goes through his free throw routine. The right-hander puts it up. And in, 4-3, Mount Vernon. Jack Amber had an open look on the three-pointer out of the right corner, hit off the back of the rim, bounced out about 10 feet. Glendale pulled it down, took it strong to the hole, and was fouled by Crakey. Glendale, second free throw, on its way. Good, 5-3, Mount Vernon, 6:28 left, first period. Rams on the road at Breeze, modern day, a non-conference game. Mount Vernon in man-to-man, Tolley another three, and he drains it, nothing but net. Knights with their first lead of the contest, 6-5.
That's the kid out of St. Rose that I saw a couple years ago down at Red Lake. He's a fine player.
Well, he needs special attention based upon the first two shots he's put up. Left wing, Gamber looks inside for Moore. Cross court pass to Deaton. Drives baseline, hands it off to Moore, and he makes it. Nice assist to Deaton.
Nice recovery as that pass nearly got away, but the good hands of Glendale Moore.
Rams on top, 7-6. Left wing, Timmerman inside. Now back out. Three put up by Donawald. No good. He missed it badly. Deaton with the rebound. Brings it up himself. This pass telegraphed. Knocked out of bounds by Timmerman. It'll be Mount Vernon basketball. Free throw line extended. Gamber throws it into Harmon. And here come the Rams. Short corner. Glendale drives baseline. It's pushed out of bounds. And it'll be modern day basketball. Good defensive play. And here comes their sophomore, sweet shooting, Kyle Tolley. Gives it off to Ryan Lake. Crakey now on top. Timmerman, left wing, Crakey. Lake wanted to put it up. Good defense by Deaton. Green's all over Timmerman. Crakey guarded by Gamber, goes between the legs. Has to hand it back to Tolley near the center circle. He goes for Ryan Lake. Lake at 6'4", doesn't set up much inside. There's an offensive foul on the Knights. Goes against Crakey, and that's his second. Comes at the 4:50 mark of the first period. We'll see if Eversgird lives him in there with two fouls. And here comes the substitution. It'll be DJ Diders, a 6'4 junior. He'll replace Crakey at the next break. Green opened in the corner. He made one from there earlier. Short corner, Glendale, they double down on him. Gamber opened up a three. Yes, Brian Gamber buries the three, and the Rams lead 10-6.
Well, you see the confidence is swelling for the Rams. Playing some good basketball now.
Crakey drives on Gamber, picks up the foul. It'll be modern day basketball out of bounds. Diders replaces Crakey.
Got the Ukrainian bodyguard over here tonight. He's in the stands with his wife, who is an alum of Breeze Modern Day High School.
Was she inducted into the Hall of Fame?
Not tonight.
Hey, that's a five-second call. They can't get it in bounds. And the Rams get it back. 4:22 left, first period. Mount Vernon 10-6 over Modern Day. Team foul ball even at two apiece. Gamber, left wing, looks inside for Glendale, cross court to Harmon. Harmon gives it to Deaton. Deaton, 18-foot baseline jumper, no good. Tipped out by Glendale, and Green runs it down. Nice play by Glendale. Used his long reach to poke that away from Donawald, who was set to clean that up. Green for three, no good. Glendale Moore and Gamber fight for it. They can't come up with it. Here comes Timmerman, pushes it up the right sideline. Three out of the corner by Diders, and he drains it.
Off the bench, he's hot.
He comes in and says, give me the ball. Feeling it. Mount Vernon by one, 10-9, 3:30 left, first period. Right wing Deaton against the 3-2. Modern day zone. Harmon. Green looks inside to Moore. Gamber, three out of the corner. Yes, Brian Gamber. Well, they've chosen. You got to pick your poison. Right. Double down on Glendale all night. The three's going to be open. Now, if they're going to come out and defend that three, then Glendale's going to get single coverage inside, and we'll put him to work.
And we got three kids who can knock the three down.
Gamber, Green, and Deaton. Gamber guards Diders out on top. Totally with a three. No good. sends it over the timeline on top Harmon. They're going to spread that 3-2 out a little bit, try to cover those lanes. There's Gamber down inside Glendale Moore, deep in the well, and he gets it off glass for the Duke.
Nice lean-in to get that one off glass.
Looks like a right-handed version of Darris Moore. Marv Everskirt's going to get a 30-second timeout. We'll be back in 30. You're listening to Auburn Basketball on WMIX.
WMIX.
Welcome back to Breeze Modern Day High School. Mount Vernon leads 15-9 with 2:20 left in the first period. Modern Day wanted to talk it over. They come out after the timeout. We'll see if they run a set play. On top, Tolley. He's guarded by Harmon. Tolley already drained two threes. He has six of their nine. Dieters with another three. All their points have come via the three-point route. Left wing, Timmerman. He looks inside. Lake. And a nice jump shot knocked down by Donowald from about 16 feet straight on.
Got the ball in the lake. They collapsed on him, and Donowald was open for him the left elbow.
They're going to extend that zone a little bit now.
Gamber
in the middle. Beautiful pass to Moore. Shot block. He gets it back and lays it in. Ryan Lake with a shot block, but it got right back to Glendale. He went back up with it and laid it over the rim.
Glendale stay with it.
Totally gives it off to Donowald. Lake looks inside, finds Donowald. Tolley almost had a shot. Good defense by Harmon. He made up for some ground. Tolley looks inside. Deaton guards Lake. Three put up. No good. Shot missed by Timmerman and rebounded by Glendale Moore. He hands it off to Harmon. And with just under a minute to play, Mount Vernon leads 17-11. Just under a minute to play in the first quarter. Gamber's going to hold it out near the center circle. And we'll get a chant of boring from the Knights student section. They're going to stay in that 3-2 zone. We'll just hold it for the final shot. We're down to 30 seconds left here in the first period. Mount Vernon 17, Modern Day 11. Creel calls out the play from the Rams bench. At the scorer's table, Bryce Dalrymple, the 6'1" senior, anxious to get into the action. We're down to 12 seconds left here in the first quarter. Harmon, Moore pops out into the corner. Deaton, he's going to launch a long three. Short, no good. Rebound. Dieters gives it off to Tolley. Three-quarter court shot, no good. At the end of one period, Mount Vernon 17, Modern Day 11. We'll be back in 60 seconds. You listen. David Farley at the end of one period, Mount Vernon 17, Modern Day 11. Modern Day with the first possession of the second quarter. Tolley comes out, dribbles right wing, hands it off. Gamber, I thought Gamber might dive on that one. Dieters couldn't handle it. Gives it off to Timmerman. Donowald, Tolley, Timmerman. They're working around the perimeter. Lake, Dalrymple into the Mount Vernon lineup. He replaced Deaton. Lake, back to Dieters, and a hand check on Gamber, and they're going to have to get Deaton back in. That's the second foul on Gamber, comes to 7:29 left in the second quarter. I hate to say it, but that was a Class A call.
That's tight.
Yeah, they wouldn't call that.
No.
Game. Sherrod Dale, Central here. Delaware West, that would be called. As it is, Monterey inbounds it. They work it around the perimeter. Tolley like to get open again. Harmon's going to try not to let that happen. Tolley with two threes in the first 2 minutes of this game. Has six of the Knights 11. Tolley on the right wing. Cross-court pass. Timmerman thought about it, then decides not to. on top of Diders. Good man-to-man by the Rams. Well, where is that call coming from? That goes on Deaton. That's his second.
Wow.
And we'll see if Creel can leave him in there with 6:58 left in the second quarter. Gamber already sitting with two fouls here in the first half. Diders gets it inbounds to Lake. Right wing, Tamarin. Lake from three, straight on. In and out, no good. Nice rebound put up and in by Donawalt.
See how we adjusted this foul trouble. We may have to slow things down a little bit.
Deaton's got to be careful right now. He's in, and nobody at the scorer's table. He's going to leave him in there with two fouls. Oh, man, if they're going to call that.
Here we go.
They just called Glendale Moore
for
backing in, or whatever you want to call it. It's a terrible call. That's the first on Glendale. Team fouls now. Mount Vernon 5, Modern Day 2. Inside Lake, 17-footer. He knocks it down. It's a two-point Mount Vernon lead, 17-15. Harmon brings it over the timeline. The Rams have yet to score here in the second quarter. They had a 17-11 lead at the end of one. Modern Day with the first 4 points here in the second quarter. Rams call out of play. Modern Day content just to sit back in that 3-2. They dump it in the short corner. Glendale shot blocked. Then they're going to call a foul on Donawalt. Glendale go to the line and shoot two.
Had the wheel play on. Glendale had 8 points in the first quarter.
Got a foul on Donawalt, his first. Glendale's free throw, good. 18-15, Mount Vernon.
Student section pretty well organized behind the Sierra.
Yeah, they do a great job over here. These kids are having fun. They're into the game. Glendale's second free throw. Bounces off, no good. Rebound by Donawalt. He gives it to Tolley, and here come the Knights. They trail by three. Tolley dribbles on top, goes right wing, Tamarin. Tamarin gives it on top to Lake. He looks left wing. Harmon was there. Lake from downtown, and we're tied.
That was what, 25 feet?
That was a bomb. 18-18 is the score. 5:20 left. Second quarter. In the corner, Dalrymple looks inside for Moore. They double down on him. Harmon kicks it to Deaton. Gets it to Moore down low into the lane. Up, no good. Air ball. And Glendale's got to be careful. Tolley gives it left wing to Lake. Dalrymple has to come out on him based on that last three. Just drain. Lake gets it down low. Fouled by Dalrymple and shot won't go.
Line
break the line. Shoot two. First foul on Dalrymple. Team foul, Mount Vernon 6, Modern Day with 3. Lake's first free throw. Good. Modern Day takes the lead, 19-18. Gamber in for Dalrymple. So Mount Vernon going to roll the dice here in the second quarter. 4:55 left. Deaton and Gamber with two fouls each. Lake makes them both, and it's a 20-18 lead. Modern Day's outscored Mount Vernon 9-1 here in the second quarter, the first 3 minutes and 10 seconds of the second period. Around the perimeter, Harmon gives it to Gamber. Deaton in the corner, dribbles it back out. Harmon on top. Harmon puts it on the floor, gives it left wing to Green. Gamber, left wing. They're going to call a foul on Lake inside against Moore. I wouldn't have called that. You know, I guess if we cry about calls against Mount Vernon, I have to say something about that. That wasn't a foul. Deaton inbounds to Harmon. Moore trying to get position inside. He better be careful with it. Deaton from three. No good. Gamber keeps it alive, puts it up and in. Brian Gamber ties it up at 20.
getting stronger on the board, getting stronger taking care of the basketball. His game's improved quite a bit.
His confidence growing with every game. Modern day working it around the perimeter against the Mount Vernon man-to-man. Dider goes left wing. Tully back to Timmerman. Timmerman to Tully in the left corner. Look inside. They're trying to get it inside. They do. Donald back out to Tully from three. Off the back of the rim. No good. Glendale Moore goes high for the rebound. Hands it off to Deaton. Deaton kicks it back to Harmon. And Harmon brings it over the timeline. We're tied at 20. 3:35 inside. Nice job knocking it out of bounds by Donald as Green tried to get it inside to Deaton on the low block. Green will inbound right in front of us. Lobs it up to Glendale in traffic. He's hammered. The other two guys weren't going to call anything. And Glendale will go to the line to shoot two.
Sleeper play again. Looked pretty well.
I guess we better not describe that too much or everybody in Southern Illinois will know about it.
Yep.
It's worked pretty well for not just this year, but for a few years. Glendale's first. Rattles in and out. No good. Into the modern day lineup. 6'5" senior Nick Feeney. There's number 52. Glendale at the line. Dribbles it three times, spins it, dribbles it twice, spins it, bends his knees, and the right-hander swishes the next one. Mount Vernon back on top, 21-20. Just over 3 minutes left here in the second quarter. Rams on the road at Breeze Modern Day. Right wing, Timmerman, guarded by Green, dribbles to the top of the key, dribbles left wing, picks it up, goes left wing to Tola, he's guarded by Harmon. Lake, way out there, gives it to Timmerman, looks inside. For Feeney. Feeney trying to post up on Glendale. Wow, they're going to call an offensive foul on Nick Feeney. And I tell you what, if the modern day fans, I guess they're used to seeing that. That wasn't a foul.
I wouldn't like it.
He was just backing in trying to establish low post position.
This kind of stuff they laugh about up north.
And that's probably why. Green from three, yes, Matt Green puts Mount Vernon back up by four to the 20-footer from the left wing. No, it's that kind of call and fouls like that is why nobody from Southern Illinois won a state championship since, what, Pinckneyville about 10 years ago?
Part of the reason.
You can't call that stuff. Got a lot of play. Lake drives back.
There you go.
Now that's a saw because Lake put out the forearm. As he was cut off on a baseline drive, got the forearm out front, and they called the offensive foul.
Not a lot of contact from Lake, but the Colkey spread that arm out there that far, and he had to call it.
That was the seventh team foul on modern day. They won't shoot, though, because it was an offensive foul. Gammer gives it right wing, Deaton. Gammer on top. Now they got Harmon playing the high post at 5'10". They get it inside to him. He dishes off to Glendale Moore. Glendale drives baseline. His shot tip, or excuse me, his pass was intercepted. And there's Tully. You better guard him. Lake drives, kicks it out. Timmerman for three. Yes. Brandon Timmerman makes it a one-point game. Mount Vernon 24, Modern Day 23 with a minute 50 left in the first half.
You can tell they're comfortable in their own gym.
Left wing Deaton. Gander cuts through. Looking for more inside. Getting a lot of attention. Gander. Right wing Harmon. Harmon kicks it to Green in the right corner. Cross court pass. Deaton inside Moore. Turns into the lane with the right hand. Baby hook no good. Keeps it alive. It's on the floor. It's out of bounds off modern day. I like that move to the inside.
Yeah, got to finish it though.
Little baby hook with the right hand. And it was just short. Hit the front of the rim. Didn't go down. There's the sleeper play again to Moore. He's hammered. No call. And here comes modern day. Timmerman brings it up. Lake guarded by Deaton. Gives it off to Dyers. Looking for a backdoor cutter. Harmon doing a good job on Tully. Now he has to come all the way out to the center circle to get it. Mark Eversberg calls out four corners, and the Knights have gone four corners here with a minute to go in the first half. Mount Vernon 24, Modern Day 23. Now the Rams look like they're going to come out and try to pressure. We'll see if we can create a steal here. Totally in the center circle. Gets it to Ryan Lake. Turns. Kicks it in the corner. Dider, double. Lake. 18-footer. No good. Glendale Moore with the rebound. Feeney went up with it. Looked like he might have caught an elbow. He went up with a big Glendale Moore. 20 seconds left. First half. Mount Vernon leads by one. 24-23. Going to start something here. Down to 10 seconds. Gives it to Deaton. Deaton inside Gamber. Puts it up. No call. Shot with block. Lake gives it to Feeney. A three. No good. At the end of the first half, Mount Vernon 24, Modern Day 23. It's Modern Day High School. Mount Vernon Rams lead by one, 24-23. They led by six at the end of the first quarter, 17-11. They were outscored 12-7 in the second period. They cling to a precarious one-point lead. I'm Rob Wilt. My broadcast partner, David Farley, has all the halftime stats. Dave, take it away.
Thank you, Rob. First for the Matterday Knights, Ryan Lake leading the way with 7 points. I assumed he was an inside player to both his baskets coming from the perimeter. 6 points from Kyle Coley on a couple of threes. 4 points from Josh Donowall. And 3 points each from Brandon Timmerman and DJ Diders. They are 7 out of 15 from the field, 5 out of 11 from three-point distance, 2 out of 2 from the free throw line, both of those from Ryan Lake, and they've committed 4 turnovers. Rams, on the other hand, led in scoring by Glendale Moore here in the first half with 10 points, 8 from Brian Gamber, and 6 points from Matt Green. Brian Deaton, we have to get him going. He has yet to dent the scoring column. We're 8 out of 17 from the field, 4 out of 8 from 3, 4 out of 6 from the free throw line, all of those coming from Glendale Moore. We've also committed 4 turnovers. Rams lead it here by 1 at the half after leading 17-11 at the quarter. And the good news there was we had a couple of fouls each on Brian Gamber and Brian Deaton, and we're able to keep those two from getting their third foul.
Thanks, Dave. Another great job on the stats. Mount Vernon Rams lead 24-23. Before the game tonight, before the broadcast, I talked at some length with their head coach, Mark Ebersberg. Tonight they were supposed to play Carbondale, and then Carbondale had an opportunity to play Chicago Westinghouse, and that game sold out at Carbondale Community High School. Westinghouse comes in ranked number 4 in the state. They are 16, maybe 18-2. Of course, Carbondale ranked 7th in the state. They've only lost twice. They lost to Memphis Sheffield. Of course, the Rams 13 days ago beat Carbondale at Carbondale, their first loss ever in their new gym. And I asked Mark, I said, is this just a one-shot deal or is it a chance we can renew this old rivalry? And he goes, we want to. He goes, we'd like to come to Mount Vernon and play you guys there next year. So hopefully this will be the start of something renewing the old rivalry between Mount Vernon and Modern Day.
Yeah, we had some games back in the 70s. The last time we played, I believe, was in 1980. And we already mentioned in the pregame, this is the school that has had a winning tradition. They've done quite well in Class A and the state tournament, and they don't mind at all playing double-A competition.
And tomorrow night, they take on Altoff. So they're used to playing South 7 Conference schools. Of course, Altoff tomorrow, Mount Vernon tonight. They originally scheduled Carbondale, so they don't back off of anyone. And as hard as it's become for Doug Creel to get quality teams to come to Shacknell Gym, Edwardsville won't come anymore, or Fallon won't come anymore. It's just so hard to get quality opponents to come to Shacknell Gym. It is a snake pit. We'll be the first to admit that. And it's just a tough scheduling job for Doug Creel, the athletic director, to get teams to come in and play Doug Creel, the basketball coach's team. It's been interesting over here tonight. Great routine between the halves of the JV game by their dance and flag team. In between games, they inducted 34 members into the Modern Day Hall of Fame, and that was great. And then here at the half, they had their symphonic band come out, got their kettle drums and the whole deal. And the somebody, what's that play? The Lionel Hampton played the xylophone. It's been great over here. We've enjoyed it. We want to thank athletic director Dennis Tromney, head coach Mark Eversberg. The hospitality has been outstanding and put us right here on the stage. And student section behind us, they're into the game, but they're
very considerate.
Yeah, they're very good kids behind us, and it's just been a great first half. Now the Rams just need to take care of business in the second half and come away with a W and get ready for Marion tomorrow night back in Shacknell Gymnasium. The Wildcats are on the road twice this week, and in other years, this would have been considered the week from, well, the week from somewhere bad, when Marion would go to Trout Gymnasium on Friday night to play the Centralia Orphans, and then have to go to Shacknell on Saturday night to play the Mount Vernon Rams. Both Mount Vernon and Centralia not quite as formidable this year as they have been in past years, but Mount Vernon on a pretty good roll, winning five in a row and claiming their ninth Salem Invitational Tournament championship in the past 16 years. Centralia had a bit of bad news this week when they found out that Jeremy Gus Moss was lost for the season with a broken wrist suffered as he was undercut last Saturday night by a Belleville East player. So our condolences go out to the Orphans. They were struggling a bit already this year, and to lose one of their best players in Moss has really got to hurt their first-year head coach, Randy Lincoln.
They're going to have to reach down to that JV team, and there's a couple of freshmen that look awfully good up there at Centralia. And, man, that's a huge loss for Gus Moss to lose him to the Orphans, because he is really about 50% of their offense. And that's not an exaggeration.
No, the other night they scored 63 points, and between Moss and Joey Parker had 56 of their 63 points. So I'm sure Coach Lincoln will like to see some of the other guys step up now if they're really needed. As we mentioned, it is halftime at Breeze Modern Day, and Mount Vernon Rams with a one-point lead, 24-23 over the Knights. We're going to take a 60-second break. You're listening to Mount Vernon Basketball on Double. You're listening to Mount Vernon Rams Basketball on WMIX 94.1 FM. We invite you to join us tomorrow morning on the AM side, the Saturday Sports Show on WMIX AM 940. That show gets underway at 8:05 after the WMIX newscast at 8 o'clock. We'll go for 55 minutes, and at 9 o'clock, you can listen to one of the many other great sports shows within our Southern Illinois listening area. Our buddies at Centralia 95.3 got a great show. Jim Muir has an outstanding show at 106.3 in Benton. And then Brad Meyer and the good guys over at Nashville 104.7 come on. I believe their show doesn't start until 10 o'clock. So lots of good Saturday morning sports talk on all of these Withers broadcasting stations throughout Southern Illinois. Mount Vernon with the first possession of this third quarter, and they turn it over. And here comes Modern Day. They dump it inside the lake, and Deaton picks up his third foul of this contest 17 seconds into the second half.
Not a good start to the Rams' third quarter. We want to see if we can get a little separation here, Rob, because we don't want this to be tight in the fourth quarter.
Well, now there's a foul on Green as he was trying to work his way around the pick by Ryan Lake. They get it inbounds. Two fouls on Mount Vernon here in the first 20 seconds of the third quarter. They get inside the lake, turn around, jump shot good. Modern Day on top, 25-24. And I think it's taking its effect on our defensive players, is now they're afraid to touch anybody. Modern Day in the 3-2 zone, they get it inside to Glendale Moore. He's fouled by Timmerman. Glendale will go to the line to shoot two.
They're going to send Glendale to the line. He was 4 out of 6 there in the first half. He was in the act of shooting.
First foul of the second half on Modern Day comes against 5'10" senior Brandon Tamerman. Glendale got the line, his first one, good. We're tied 25 all, 7:16 left third quarter. Glendale wears number 42. Rams in their orange road jerseys. Black numerals turned in white. Second free throw. In and out. No good. We remain tied at 25. Just over 7 minutes left here in the third quarter. Mount Vernon at modern day non-conference encounter. They dump it down inside the lake. He throws it away. Deaton dives and knocks it out of bounds. And he's lucky he didn't touch Brandon Timmerman. That would have been a fourth on Deaton. Out of bounds right there at the official scorer's table. Tolley guarded by Harmon. Gives it to Krakey. Inside, leg spins, in traffic, short, no good. Rebound Gamber after Glendale Moore kept it alive. Gamber brings it up. Thought about it. Gives it to Deaton. He launches a three out of the corner. Long, no good. Offensive rebound Green. Then he scores off glass.
Nice weak side rebound there from Matt Green as the rebound went long.
Mount Vernon with a two-point lead, 27-25, 6.5 left here in the third period. They dump it inside. Double down, shot partially blocked. Glendale comes out of there with it. Mount Vernon going to try to break. Then it's stolen and recovered by Tolley. Nice job by Tolley. And he slaps at Glendale Moore. Mount Vernon in a man-to-man. They go back door to Tolley. Stop, cut off, good backside help from Glendale Moore. Mount Vernon by two. Tolley on the left wing, gives it to Krakey. He's guarded by Deaton, drives on Deaton, and Deaton picks up his fourth foul. Here comes Bryce Dalrymple. Deaton's going to have to sit for an extended period of time. His fourth foul coming at the 5:50 mark of the third quarter. Krakey will inbound right in front of us. We're set up on the stage here at Modern Day's gym. Gets it inbound to Timmerman, guarded by Green. Dalrymple guards Krakey. That means Harmon still on the sophomore Tolley. They're going to go four corners. We'll let them just hold the ball for the rest of the quarter, I'm sure.
Yeah.
Mount Vernon up by two, 27-25.
We won't have a problem with this, with Deaton in foul trouble.
Creel talking to his assistant coach, Quinn McClure. Good to see Tim Holloway back after suffering a rough bout with the flu last week. Now here comes Modern Day. They decided not to hold it. Working against the Rams man-to-man. They're still in the four corners, though. Krakey out near the center circle. Head coach Mark Eversberg says, let's hold it, boys. Head coach Doug Creel says, we'll let you.
While they're doing this, we mentioned that Brian Deaton went down into the locker room with the trainer. Don't know what that was about, but he didn't seem to be hurt.
Nothing serious, I hope.
Yeah.
Mount Vernon out. Forced the issue a little bit. Still in the man. Now Eversberg calls out a play from the modern day bench. Tolley cuts through. Looks like they're running a little lead. Krakey hands it off to Tolley. Timmerman. Gives it to Krakey. He's dribbling on top, tries to break down Dalrymple, drives into Moore, and it's stolen. Here comes Moore on a breakaway, finger roll, no good. Tolley with the rebound. He's got to use the backboard on
yeah,
that.
Sure does.
If he uses the backboard, it's a deuce. Donald in the corner, back on top, Tolley. He dribbles near center circle.
Here comes Brian Deaton back.
Pick. Inside. No, they look inside. It's not there. Tolley. He's going to drive on Harmon. Gets it back to Krakey. He's guarded by Dalrymple. They're working around the perimeter. Now Timmerman. Down low leg. Double down on him. Timmerman with a three. And Modern Day on top, 28-27.
They've done a good job on the threes. They're 6 out of 12 from there now.
They tried to help down. Gamber had leg down low. When they dumped it down in, but they kicked it right back out. Gamber from three. Short. No good. Dalrymple keeps it alive. Moore comes up with it, lays it up and in. Mount Vernon back on top, 29-28.
Kept it alive.
3 minutes left, third period. Let's see if Modern Day decides to hold it again this possession. They do not. They're into their offense. Tully dribbles left. Looks inside. Launches a three as Harmon went down. Moore goes high for the rebound. Puts it on the floor and gives it to Gamber. He didn't want to get it stolen again. Gamber over the timeline. Harmon on top. Modern Day been in his 3-2 all night long. In the corner, Gamber. Back to Harmon. Green. Gamber cuts through in the other corner. Inside to Moore. He turns on Lake, puts it up, and it's blocked from behind by Lake. Gotta be stronger. And inside, they try to get it inside. They do. Nearly stolen by Harmon as Donawal kicks it back outside to Tully. Timeout, Modern Day. We'll be back in 30 seconds. You're listening to Mount Vernon Basketball on WMIX. School for the Mount Vernon Rams hold a precarious 29-28 lead. 2 minutes, 12 seconds left, third period. Dave, it's been almost a chess match. I won't go so far as to say like last Friday when we played Edwardsville. Of course, Friel and Mike Waldo going at it. Oh, here they get it inbounds, take a wild shot. Lindell Moore cleans the glass. And we've got a foul on Cranky as he hit Dalrymple in the back. And he doesn't like the call. That's his third.
Well, Eversgaard has been at this for a long time. You mentioned this isn't his first rodeo.
That's
he
right.
Knows how to coach in this gym, there's no doubt.
He's playing it close to the vest, and Doug Friel doing the same. It's a low-scoring affair. Gamber working against the 3-2 zone. In the corner, Dalrymple thought about the three. Short corner to Moore. Can he make a move? No, back to Dalrymple. Back inside to Moore. The little two-man game. Moore puts a shot up. Won't go. Dalrymple tries to keep it alive. He draws the foul. Well, what Lindell's got to do when he turns into the lane and gets his man up in the air, and that guy starts to come down, you need to just jump up, lead with that elbow, get draw that foul, and go to the line. That foul on Dalrymple, his second. 90 seconds left in the third period. Mount Vernon by one, 29-28. They look inside for Lake. It's not there. A three put up by Donawal. No good. Gamber with the rebound, and he's fouled by Timmerman. Second foul of the contest on Timmerman. Team fouls in the second half. Mount Vernon with 4, Modern Day with 3. A minute 10 left, third quarter. Mount Vernon by 1, 29-28. Hasn't been any scoring this game for a while, has there?
After 17 points in the first quarter for Mount Vernon.
Inside, Lindell Moore kicks it out to Green, a three. Yes, Matt Green buries the three, and the Rams on top by 4.
A little breathing room.
Nice kick out by Lindell Moore. Tully over the timeline. Gives it to Timmerman. They're going to go 4 corners. Hold for the final shot. Mount Vernon 32, Modern Day 28. 35 seconds left in the third period. Creel tells the Rams to come out on him. Force the issue. They do. Now Modern Day goes to a 3-man lead out near the center circle. Tully guarded by Harmon. 15 seconds left in the third period. Tully picks up his dribble. He's in trouble. Finds Lake. Lake turns, about to make a move on Gamber. Kicks it out. 3 put up. Oh, in by Brandon Timmerman. Now Harmon with 4 seconds. 3. Dalrymple going to shoot. A 3-quarter. No. Rims out. Got a good look there at the buzzer at the end of 3 quarters. Mount Vernon 32, Modern Day 31. We'll all at the end of 3 periods. Mount Vernon 32, Modern Day 31. I'm Rob Wilk alongside Dave Farley. Dave, this is a great basketball game.
And a great atmosphere for basketball here in Breeze Modern Day, too.
Yeah, they got a good-looking crowd here today.
Sure do. You know, this is such an important game, too, for Mount Vernon. Just because it's not a conference game, it's sectional seeding time coming up very soon. Every win is important.
Well, we've got some discussion going on here. I'm not sure what the problem is. And, we've got a little blood on the court. I wonder who's bleeding. We're going to mop up some blood. give you the scoring by quarters. Mount Vernon led 17-11 at the end of one period. They were outscored 12-7 and took a 24-23 lead into the halftime locker room. Both teams with 8 points in the third quarter, and Mount Vernon clinging to a one-point lead. It's 32-31. And I'm not sure who was bleeding. Maybe that was why Deaton had to go to the locker room after his fourth foul.
And he got the spray out cleaning the area.
Well, they've got several spots at both ends of the court, so they're going to get it all cleaned up. A lot different than it used to be when they were, but I guess with the way things are.
I remember an altercation down at Heron one night, way back when we were in high school. It just kept right on going, didn't it?
Yeah, that was quite a night, wasn't it?
Yeah, boy.
Have I told that story lately?
Yeah, it looks like we're not going to have time now, right?
Thank goodness. All right, this is the first possession of the fourth quarter. Mount Vernon 32, Modern Day at home 31. See if the Rams can get a road victory against the Modern Day Knights as these two high schools renew an old rivalry. We believe this is the first time they've played in 25 years. Ryan Lake in the right corner. He's guarded by Brian Gamber. They look it around. They get it inside. Dieters back out to Lake. On top, they've got the Donnerwall. This is the biggest lineup they've shown all night long. Dieters looks inside, looking for Lake. Goes back on top. Curry put up. No good. Harmon with the rebound. He kept it alive and got it to Green. Donnerwall three. Wouldn't go. Here come the Rams with a one-point lead. Modern Day still in that 3-2 zone. Harmon, his pass intercepted. Here comes Tully on a breakaway. He's up and in. Harmon with a bad pass out front. Tully took it to distance. Modern Day on top, 33-32. Cross court pass, Dalrymple looks inside for more. Now Harmon, Gamber. Back to Harmon. Dalrymple, thought about the three from the right wing. He does launch the three. It's short. Air ball, he missed badly. And Moore tried to save it. Here comes Deaton back in the lineup. He replaces Dalrymple. Deaton with four fouls. Hasn't been much of a factor here tonight. He was a second team all tournament at Salem last week.
Had not scored tonight. What we need him.
Full court pressure from the Rams. They trail by one. Timmerman gets it to Donnerwall. Tully inside Dieters on the floor, back out. Lake, he's going to drive into Moore. Shot blocked. They're going to call a foul on Glendale Moore.
Yeah, they have to call that. We're mad about that one.
That foul on Glendale, his second, comes with 6:25 left, fourth period. Lake at the line, a 6'4" senior, rattles in and out, no good. Kirky back in for Modern Day, he replaces Dieters. Team fouls in the second half, Mount Vernon with five, Modern Day with three. He makes the second, it's a 2-point Modern Day lead, 34-32. 6:20 left, fourth quarter action. There's a foul on the inside. My goodness.
In the vicinity of Brian Deaton, we held our breath.
They called on Ryan Lake, his third. Oh, my goodness. Deaton just fouls out on an offensive pick.
It's not on Deaton.
What are they going to say?
Is it just a violation?
What, did we throw that in bat? We were it? Stepping on the end line or something?
Had to be something
like
that.
I thought it was a foul. I guess not. Donnerwall back out to Tully. Mount Vernon trails by two. 6 minutes left. Tully left wing on top. Cranky. Timmerman. Donnerwall. Cranky. Tully. They work it around the perimeter. Not dribbling, just passing. They'd like to dump it inside the lake. Shot put up and in. They found Donnerwall on the back door. Modern Day with a four-point lead. Creel's going to get a full timeout. We'll be back in 60 seconds. You're listening to Mount Vernon Basketball on WMIS.
Let's take it back out. Mount Vernon Rams Basketball with Rob Wilt and Dave Farley on WMIS.
Mount Vernon trails by four, and Deaton walks with the ball. Turnover gives it back to Modern Day with 5:33 left in the fourth. The Knights lead 36-32. Mount Vernon hasn't looked very good since the first quarter. Intercepted by Deaton. Can he save it? No. He goes into the scorer's table. Randy Ola a little gun-shy over there after Harmon knocked Stephen Haynes into the scorer's table at Carbondale. Ola came out of there a little gimpy. Modern Day inbounds. Mount Vernon with full court man-to-man pressure. Coley goes around Harmon. Picks up his dribble. Gets it off to Ryan Lake. He's guarded by Gambler. Deaton comes out on Creighton. To go right wing to Timmerman. Dribbles the top of the key, picks up his dribble, now in trouble. Gets it to Tully. Tully open. Now finds Krakey. Lake. Guarded by Gambler. Gives it off to Krakey. Throws the top of the key. Gives it back door. Tully. Donald inside. Gets a kind bounce. And it's a 6-point Modern Day lead. And we've got an injured player, an official's timeout. He's all right. He's going to stay in there. That's Krakey. I don't know if he slightly rolled his ankle. Eversberg's going to leave him in there. Green might be able to take advantage of that. Green in the corner. Thought about it. Cross court back to Harmon. Deaton in the other corner. A three. Short. No good. Rebound by Lake, and the Rams are in serious trouble. Gambler fighting hard. Pokes it away and gets it. Nice job by Brian Gambler. Glendale Moore takes it up. Blocking foul. Shot won't go. Totally barks about the call. See if Glendale knocks that down. Now he's got to make these free throws. 4:18 left in the fourth period. Mount Vernon trails 38-32.
Modern Day fans didn't like the call, but you can't draw a charge sitting up underneath the basket like that.
Well, you can't in the NBA, but I've seen that call high school many a time. Glendale Moore, first for two. No good, in and out.
Not looking good for the Rams tonight. Not making the shots, not making the plays.
No, we scored 17 points in the first quarter, and we've only scored 15 since. 4 minutes, 18 seconds left in the fourth period. Glendale Moore. Trying to salvage back in with his two shot. He gets it to go. And hats off to Brian Gambler. He worked hard to get that steal after the miss. Mount Vernon in a full court press. Lake gets it to Krakey. Krakey over the timeline. Finds Tully. Harmon tries to go back door for the steal. Lake from three. No good. And then Moore rebounds at the Rams trail by five, 38-33. Under 4 minutes to go. Deaton inside to Moore. He works his way down in and scores.
Now he did that with authority.
It's a three-point game. Mount Vernon takes a timeout with 3:48 left in the fourth period. It's a full. We'll be back in 60. You're listening to Mount Vernon Basketball.
Let's take it back out. Mount Vernon Rams Basketball with Rob Wilson and Dave Farley live on WMIX.
All right, Mount Vernon trails 38-35. Three-quarter court. They go long. Intercepted by Green. Oh, but he can't corral it before it goes out of bounds. That was an ill-advised inbound pass. They tried to throw long. Green had it stolen, but he stumbled and fell before he could get control. And they're going to mop up a little perspiration where Green did a slide. 3 minutes, 47 seconds left, fourth period. Modern Day, 38. Mount Vernon, 35. Team fouls. Mount Vernon with six in the second half. Modern Day with five. Timmerman will inbound. Free throw line extended. Creel has his original starting lineup in there. Moore, Gambler, Deaton, Green, and Harmon. They get it into Tully. Harmon comes out on him. picks up his dribble, goes to Cranky. Right wing, Tamarin, left, throws Gamber out of the way, and it's an offensive foul. And that, I believe that's the fourth on their 6'4 senior, Ryan Lake. Yes, that's four team fouls now, all even at six apiece. May become a free throw shooting contest here in the last 3 minutes and 40 seconds. Green, they look inside to Moore. Gamber, for three, Gamber! Oh, it won't go! Green, excuse me, Moore over the back of Lake. And I believe that's four on Glendale, and that'll send Ryan Lake to the line to shoot the front end of a 1-1.
Boy, Brian Gamber's shot from three-point distance at the front of the rim, and just hung there, and it bounced just a little bit away.
Well, it kind of bounced like that Northwestern shot at the end of overtime. Bounced twice and fell through to beat Iowa by one. Lake's first free throw.
No, he got the rope.
There's a kind bounce. Puts Mater Dei up 39-35. That foul on Moore was his fourth. Came at the 3:31 mark of the fourth period. Lake's second free throw. Good. Nothing but net. It's a five-point Mater Dei lead. 3.5 to go. Harmon pushes it. Throws a terrible pass. Lucky to get it back. Gets it to Green. Toe on the line. It's long. Rebound Lake, and the Rams are in trouble. 3 minutes, 15 seconds to go. They trail by five, 40-35. Toley picks up his dribble, finds Lake. Lake turns into Gamber, and he's fouled by Brian Gamber. He'll go to the line to shoot 1-1. Period. That foul on Gamber was his third. Right,
Lake at 12 points.
First one, no good. Rebound. It's on the floor. Gamber fights for it. They're going to call a jump ball. Possession arrow in favor of Mount Vernon. Lake did the Rams a favor by missing the front end of a 1-1. Mount Vernon trails by 5, 40-35, 3:06 left in the fourth period. Gamber inbounds to Harmon. He lets it roll to midcourt, picks it up. Here comes the Rams, still working against that 3-2 Mater Dei zone. Green on top to Harmon. They sag off of him. Bounce pass in the corner to Deaton. A dangerous pass.
There was.
Cross court to Green. Touch pass to Harmon. In the corner, Green open for three. Yes, Matt Green makes it a two-point game. 40-38 with 2:45 left. Cranky beats the penetration, finds Lake to Timmerman. Timmerman out front, Cranky. He's guarded by Deaton. Deaton with four fouls, has to be careful. He spins, gives it off to Timmerman. Timmerman looks inside for Lake. Finds Toley out near the center circle. They double-team him. They find Donawald. Now, excuse me, Mater Dei working well. Lake charges. Oh! That's terrible! They call a foul on Gamber as Lake charged into Gamber. Foul with 2:16 left in the fourth period.
Gamber had position. He came in for the block, and, well, what can you say? Rob said it all for you.
That's nine fouls on Mount Vernon. This will be the last 1-1. Lake makes the front end.
Back to the three-point lead, 41-38.
Misses the second. Green with the rebound. Finds Deaton. The Rams can tie it with a three. Deaton to Harmon on top. Green, they work around the perimeter. Gamber looks inside for more. Green for three. Yeah, we're tied. 41 all. Timeout Mount Vernon with 1:57 left.
That's hot.
That foul on Gamber there before was his fourth. It's a full. We'll be back in 30 seconds. You're listening to Mount Vernon basketball on WNIA. He's Mater Dei High School. 1 minute, 57 seconds remaining in the fourth quarter. Green's three has just tied it up, 41-41. The Knights will have possession. Mount Vernon will pull back from the full court press following the Rams timeout. Well, I said they will, but now they're going to wait for him at midcourt. Cranky to inbound to Toley. Here come the Knights. Garmin works Toley. Oh, he picks up his dribble.
Yeah, he did.
Finds Donawald. on top. Lake open is Toley. Back on top. Now they swing around the right side. Cranky drives into the paint, kicks it back to Timmerman. Out front, now Cranky guarded by Gamber. They're going to try to post up Lake down low on Deaton. 128 left, fourth quarter. We're tied at 41. And an offensive foul on Ryan Lake. Brian Deaton draws the offensive foul as Lake cut through the middle. It is terrible. I don't care if I'm a Mount Vernon broadcaster or a modern-day fan. These calls, I tell you, you get an opportunity to check them out for yourself. Some of the calls are such a mystery that even Monday night on Charter Communications, I don't know where you're going to see some of these fouls. Best in the business, did you have that one? He's got that process.
All right.
All right, here's Brian Deaton to shoot the front end of the 1-1. His first free throw. No good, he missed it. We're still tied at 41. Timeout, Modern Day with 1:19 remaining. We'll keep it right here.
Brian Deaton had a chance. Sorry, Rob.
No, go ahead.
Brian
go
Deaton
ahead.
Had a chance to give us a lead. Would have been his first point of the game. That's how it's gone for him tonight. He's had four fouls since early in the third quarter. Now, our average guard will, if he can come up with a play, you think they're going to hold it?
Yeah, I think they'll try to hold it for the last shot, if they can. They've shown a little patience, but I don't know if they can hold it for 79 seconds. Yeah, Deaton's free throws off the front of the rim. I thought he might get the bounce up and over the front of the rim, but it came right back out. Modern Day rebounded. Their head coach, Marv Eversgert, in his fourth year as the head coach. He was an assistant for 14 years. 1 minute, 19 seconds to go. Team foul, Mount Vernon with 9. So the next foul on the ramp will send Modern Day to the line, shoot 2. The Knights with 7 fouls here in the second half. Deaton just missed the front end of a 1-1 that would have put the Rams on top. He's still mad about it.
Gotta forget about it.
Yeah, you gotta get over that. Play some defense right now. That was the 5th foul on Ryan Lake.
Yeah.
And he's gone for the night. Totally over the timeline. Picked up by Harmon. Goes left. Gives it back to Cranky. He's guarded by Green. Rams are going to try to double out of this. Finds Cranky in the corner. They double him, looking cross-court pass. Toley, minute to play. Toley doubled. He finds Deiters. Back to Cranky. They're working it as best they can. Rams chasing. We're tied at 41. Timmerman in the corner, cross-court. Deiters back out front. Toley. They work it around the perimeter. Rams try to double Timmerman. He finds Cranky. The inside man is Donowalk. They get to use him. The 4 guys on the perimeter are doing a good job of holding it. We're down to 30 seconds left. Toley drives, kicks it to Donowalk. He passed up the shot. Eversgert's going to get a timeout. It's a full. We'll be back in 30 seconds. Breeze Modern Day High School. The Mount Vernon Rams and the Breeze Modern Day Knights are tied with 41 apiece. 27.4 seconds remain in the fourth quarter. Dave, this has been a great game from the get-go.
Sure has. It looked like Mount Vernon was going to take charge when they went ahead 17-11. But Breeze Modern Day would have none of that. They're going to have the ball out on the far side.
Timmerman to inbound. Looking. Goes long to Cranky. 25 seconds left. Fourth quarter. We're tied at 41. Donowalk. They're working around the perimeter. 16 seconds. Toley guarded by Harmon. He's going to drive. Spins. He loses it. And Toley hammers. Going to go to the line to shoot 1-1 with 9 seconds remaining. Toley tried to make a move down the middle. He lost control of the ball. Moore came out of there with it, and Toley got him with a cross body block with 9 seconds left. It's a front end of a 1-1 for Glendale Moore. Foul on Toley, his 2nd.
Well, Glendale, just like he did down at Carbondale.
These are huge.
Handed the ball to him.
Handed the ball to him, and Modern Day was still awarded a timeout. You don't see that very often.
No, you don't.
Let's see, what is it, a full? We'll be back in 30 seconds. 9 seconds remaining. Glendale Moore at the line to shoot the front end of the 1-1. We're tied 41-41. And now what? Now the official scores table honking the buzzer. If Glendale makes this, it'll be the greatest free throw I've ever seen. It's on its way. No good. Green with a rebound. He comes out of it with it. 6 seconds left. Inside the board. In traffic. Moore. 2 seconds left. They inbound. Calling from 3-quarter court. No good. Rams win. 43-41. A huge victory on the road. It breezed my day. Woo! A huge offensive rebound by Matt Green after the missed free throw by Glendale Moore. He got it to Deaton. I think it was Deaton. Saw Moore open underneath. Moore scored with about 2.5 seconds to go. Bonner Day didn't get a timeout. Totally from 3-quarter court. Couldn't go. The final score, Mount Vernon 43, Bonner Day 41. We're going to be back in 3 minutes. I'm Rob Wilt alongside Dave Farley. Man, what a great basketball game we just had here at Breeze Modern Day. The Rams come out on top 43-41, and it wasn't easy by any stretch of the imagination. The Rams led 17-11 at the end of one period. They were outscored 12-7 in the second quarter. They took a 24-23 lead into the halftime locker room. Both teams scored 8 points in the third period. The Rams were up 32-31. And in the fateful final fourth quarter, the Rams outscored Modern Day 11-10 to pull off a 43-41 victory. After we get done with the stats, Dave Farley working feverishly to my right, getting the final stats. We've got the play of the game, and I can pretty much tell you what it was. It was Matt Green with the offensive rebound. At this end of the court, Tolley tried to go one-on-one against Harmon, lost the ball. Moore came out of there with it. Tolley fouled Moore with 9 seconds to go. He shot the front end of a 1-1. First, let me go back all the way to this. First, they had handed him the ball, and then they allowed Modern Day head coach Marv Eversker to get a timeout after they had already handed the ball to Glendale Moore at the line. After the timeout, they handed the ball to Glendale Moore. Then the official scores table, for whatever reason, honks the buzzer. Can you honk the buzzer? Buzz the buzzer. Glendale Moore looks over like, what? Coach Creel looks and says, what? And the referee just goes, oh, go ahead and shoot. Go ahead and shoot. They should have reloaded the whole thing right then.
Yeah.
Took the ball back, said, all right, is everything okay? You guys at the table all right? That's actually, in my opinion, a cheap hustle to buzz that buzzer while the kids got the ball at the line. And then when they looked at the scores table to say, you know, is something wrong? They go, oh, no, we just accidentally hit the buzzer. And maybe it was an accident. Maybe I shouldn't condemn those guys. But to me, it didn't appear quite Hoyle. Anyway, Glendale Moore then misses the front end of a 1-1. But Mount Vernon Rams, Matt Green with an offensive rebound with 9 seconds to go. They got it back outside. And I want to say it was Deaton that saw Glendale open underneath, dumped it down inside. Glendale Moore scored in traffic with about 2.5 seconds to go. Modern Day inbounded. The sophomore Tolley couldn't connect from 3-quarter court. And the Rams come out of there with a 43-41 victory in a game in which they trailed. I want to say they trailed 40-35 with under 3 minutes to play.
We were down 38-32. I remember that.
That's true. Trailed by 6 in the fourth quarter. Dave Farley, have I stretched long enough?
You stretched more than enough, and I'm sure the fans out there enjoyed that description of those final harrowing moments.
Except for the people that are related to the guy at the official scores table that was buzzing the buzzer.
I doubt that there's any of those folks listening, nonetheless.
We still got to get out of here.
Good point. We got the Ukrainian bodyguard. We have the main man, the big bodyguard to our right here, the best in the business. For the Modern Day Knights, Ryan Lake, before fouling out in the fourth quarter, finishes with 13 points. 9 points from Brandon Timmerman. 8 apiece from Kyle Tolley and Josh Donowall. And DJ Divers had the three-pointer. They were 14 out of 28 from the field, even 50%. 7 out of 17 from 3. They were 6 out of 9 from the free throw line. and they committed 9 turnovers. For the Rams, we reverted to our old ways tonight in one sense. They pulled out a victory, but the old ways was only having 3 guys in the scoring column. Luckily, we had enough of that. 18 points, Glendale Moore, and 17 for Matt Green. I believe that's his high game of the year. And 8 points from Brian Jammer. Brian had all his points in the first half, and we survived this game despite Brian Deaton being shut out. And that's huge to be able to win without him scoring. Rams were 15 out of 34 from the field, 7 out of 17 from 3, just like Modern Day was. Only 6 out of 12 from the free throw line. We had shot so well from there, I guess we better stop bragging. Namely, myself, better stop bragging about how well we're shooting the free throws. Committed only 8 turnovers, and boy, Matt's gotten some offensive rebounds off of his free throws this year, but none bigger than that one he got off of Glendale's miss. And Glendale, in the fourth quarter, did a much better job receiving the pass and going hard to the hole. And he banked it off glass, and the Rams will go 11-7 and feel a lot better tomorrow morning waking up with a win.
That's true. Great job, Dave Farley. Mount Vernon wins their 6th game in a row. They are 11-7 on the year. Modern Day falls to 11-12 overall. They've got Belleville Altoff tomorrow night. The Rams will be back at home in the friendly confines of historic Shagnon Gymnasium, where they'll take on the Marion Wildcats. Wow. Any final comments?
Well, I think I said everything I needed to say. I'm just going to feel a lot better in the morning. And I'm sitting here thinking, we're going to wind up losing this game, going 10-8, and the win against Carbondale, the win against Edwardsville, and the championship against Salem isn't going to mean a thing. But thank goodness we pulled it out. We're showing some maturity, being able to win a game like this, not playing very well.
Thank you, Dave. For Carlos Vasquez, back in the studio. For the best in the business, Jeff Grove from Charter Communications. You'll be able to watch a replay of tonight's Mount Vernon at Breeze Modern Day on Charter Communications Cable Channel 10, Monday night at 8 o'clock. For my broadcast partner, Dave Farley, for my lucky underwear, they're still holding in there. People will want to give me a lot of room tomorrow night. Shagnon Gymnasium.
April's going to be so proud.
Yeah, April's not going to be too pleased when I get home tonight. But anyway, I'm Rob Wilt. The final score, Mount Vernon Rams 43, the Breeze Modern Day Knights 41. And that's a beautiful thing.